Do you know how you can connect your Power App to the data source like Excel, Spreadsheet, Google Sheet, or even the data which is there in your computer? Hi, this is Krupali from KnowHow Academy. So let's start with me. In this video, we are going to see how we can connect our Excel file which is there in a Google Drive to the Power App, and also we will see how we can connect our Excel file which is there in a Google Drive. So here is my Excel sheet which I upload on my Google Drive. So it contains the employee information like employee first name, last name, position, email ID, employee status. So several information is there. So what I want? I want to display this information using Power App like this. Now here in this left hand side, you will able to see all employee information with their image, ID, and what is the gender of that employee and what rating is of that employee. So how can I do that? So for that, you need to use a gallery control. So in gallery control, you will able to display set of employee data. Now when I click on that button, you will able to see the detail of that selected employee. Let's say here that employee information I want to see. So I will click on that and you will able to see the detail of that employee here. How can I do that? So let's create one app. So click on create a blank app, create it and give a name that is demo Excel. Click on create and then here you need to add one gallery control in that. So here this is called vertical gallery. From layout also you will able to see different kind of gallery which is available. So from here also you can select. So I am adding a gallery control in that. Now here first if you add the gallery control, it will display some dummy data. Now I want to display the information which is there in that Excel file. So what I need to do? So here I need to click on that database symbol or you can click on add data. Now here you need to select a connector. Now what is the job of connector? The job of connector will connect your Power App to the Excel. So for particular data source, there are particular connectors available. So for Google Excel, there is a connector called Google Sheet. So you need to select the Google Sheet. If you are not able to see Google Sheet, let's say if you click here and you click on add data and you will not able to find Google Sheet. So here you need to write it Google Sheet. Click on that and here you will able to see the email ID using which you are logging in your browser. If you are not able to see, you need to select the email ID. So I can see my email ID by default. So click on that and here from your Google Drive, whatever Excel file is there, you will able to see that Excel file here. So here you will able to see employee data. So this is the sheet name you will able to see here. So here I'm selecting the sheet name and click on connect. So here it will be added. Now here in this gallery control, I want to connect this Excel file. So here from data source, I need to select the connector which I added. So I'm selecting the Google Sheet. Okay, so here you will able to see the employee data. Now see, in my app, I am able to see the employee information that is photograph, email ID and mail. But here, you are able to see some number and the birth date of the employee. So how can I change that? So here there is a property called field. You need to click on edit and here you can select instead of 4, that is actually employee rating. So you can select the email ID. And here instead of birth date, you can select the, let's say gender. So you will able to see like that. Okay, you can select the any of the layout, whatever you like. Okay, you can try out after seeing the video. Okay, then let's say you want to increase or decrease the height and width. So from here, you can increase or decrease the height or as well as width. Okay, then you want to give a background color like this. So how can you give that? So here from the color section, you can change the background color, or here there is one of the property called template fill. So if you just scroll it down, you will able to see template fill. So here you can say you can set any color. So let's say color dot you want antique white, so you will able to see. So you can select any of the color, and let's say between the two employee information you want more space, so there is an option called template padding. So by default size is 0, you can add more padding, so you will able to see this space, left side space, right side space, top down space is increased. So you can try out that. Okay, so you will able to see. The next thing is that when you run the application, let's save and run, you will able to see this, whatever is selected that is coming. So this way you can format your gallery. Now in this app, see, when I click here on, let me run and show you again, when I click here in this section of screen, the detail information is there, or the detail information you are able to see. So what you need to do for that? So in Power App there is one control called form control. So how you can edit? So go to the insert and search for edit form. So you need to click on, so form will automatically edit, adjust the position of the form. Then in a data source you need to select that connector. So here I'm selecting the data source, and still I select the data source, but still you will not able to see anything. So what you need to write? So here in gallery control, you need to click on that, and here select parent. So instead of that, you need to write, okay, before that, let me show you what is the name of that control. So let's say you can give any name to that control. So here my gallery control name is gallery 1. So you can right click and rename it here, or from rename it here. So let's say employee data. Okay, so your control name will be employee data. Now this is the form. So here the control name you want to rename it as a form of employee. Always give a meaningful name to the control, so in future when you use for some coding, so you will able to understand easily. Okay, so here in employee data source, here in a form there is a property called data source. So here by default we set it at the employee data. Now here there is a property called item. Now in item property, whatever it is selected, I want to display it here. So in a form control, in item property, you need to write the name of the gallery control, that is employee underscore data dot selected. Selected means whatever it is select. Now just save and run it. Still you are not able to see. So let's see why it is like that. Okay, employee data, and here you need to add the fields. Why? Because you need to add what information you want to see. So I want to see, let's say first name, then last name, you need to add it. So here you will, so let me add one more field, let's say date of birth. I want to see in which division he or she is working, that is department. Then email ID I am displaying, then employee ID, then employee classification type, employee status. Here you will able to see all the columns which is available in your Excel sheet. Okay, so here Excel sheet, I think 12 or 13 columns are there. So here in Power App you need to add whatever fields you want to see. So let's say I'm employing start date, state, termination, description, I don't want to edit. Then I want to add the performance, position. Let's click and edit. So here you will able to see whatever the information is edited. Let's save and run it. Okay, so let me click on that, you will able to see the information. Okay, if you click on that, you will able to see. Okay, so here you can create a screen which will display the employee data in gallery control, which is some of the important data. But if you want to see all the information of employee, then you need to add the information, you need to add the form control, and inform control, you will able to see. One important thing you need to remember is that in gallery control, on that button that is called on select button, make sure it is blank. And as well as inform control, you need to select the item, and in here you need to write the name of the gallery control dot selected. So this way you will able to see data in the form control. I have same Excel file in my OneDrive. Now what I want to do, I want to connect that Excel file to my Power App which is there in a OneDrive. Now same way, I have the same Excel file in my OneDrive, and if I want to connect my OneDrive Excel file to the Power App, how can I do that? Previously we have seen how we can connect our Google Sheet to the Power App. Now next, we are going to see how we can connect our Excel file which is there in my Google Drive to the Power App. So again, I am adding one new screen and adding a gallery control. Then let me add data. Click on the connector. This time I need to search for OneDrive connector. Okay, so I am selecting OneDrive for business. And by default, using whatever mail I have logged in, you will able to see here this mail. Okay, then here in that I have several Excel file, and my name of the Excel file is employee data. So I'm selecting the employee data, but here you will not able to see anything. In Google Sheet, if you are selecting, you will able to see the sheet name. Now why it is like that? Because when your Excel is in OneDrive, you need to make the entire table as a mark as a table. So how you can do that? So open the file which is there in your OneDrive and select the entire sheet by just like this, and go to the last till the last record is there. Let's say my last record is there in 400 something. So go to the last and select the entire data. Do not forget a single column. And then you need to go to format table and consider it as a any of the style sheet. So you are formatting it as a table, and when you format it, one option will be the table design, and you need to give a name that is employee data, and just hit enter and make sure it is saved. Then go to the Power App, okay, save it, and just one time refresh it. Sometime your app will be marked as a read only, so click on override. Go to the second screen that you have taken, and then click on add data and search for OneDrive for business. Select that, add that, and this time again select that particular file. Still you are not able to see, so just make sure it refresh properly. Business, and then make sure employee data, and here this you will able to see. So here the name you will able to see, what name you have given to that. Okay, so here I am selecting this sheet that is employee data, which is the name of the table which I mark it as a format as table. So click on connect, and here in data source select the data. Okay, and here from the edit fields I am selecting, instead of date of birth I want to see the department, and instead of this per rating I want to see the email ID. You will able to see. Okay, and here again I am adding the form control, edit form. I'm doing little bit fast because I already show you how you can view the data using Excel from Google. So select that, here in data source select the same data source, and here in fields you need to add whatever fields you want to edit. So I am selecting this time all the fields. You can select whatever your wish. And click on add, so all text box or all fields will be added. Thank you for choosing KnowHow Academy as your source of IT knowledge. We are always here to help you to navigate to the tech world. If you have any question, don't hesitate to reach out us. It has been a pleasure to share this information with you. Stay curious and keep learning.